So hey, what's up mga kote? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Quadernos, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para may update ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Quadernos. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is about position. Hindi yung kanta ni Ariana Grande, positions ha. It's all about science. So the next ko lang yung libro natin. So, dito na tayo sa ating positions. So, ang next natin dito is about machines. Yung mga ginagamit nating dating tools for to lessen yung bigat sa work. So, yan. Meron tayong machines, safety on road, ganyan. So, before we start that, meron muna tayong trivia for today. So, next natin. So, the brand name of Spam is the combination of spice and ham. So, yan yung mga paboritong pinapadala sa akin ng lola ko before. So, yung Spam na yan, it was my favorite canned goods na binibigay sa akin from other, galing ibang bansa. So, hindi talaga nawawala yung Spam kapag binibigyan ako ng lola ko. Kasi alam niya ang paborito ko and favorite ko. So, yung Spam na yan, it's from spice and ham. So, Spam. So, masarap talaga siya. I think it's a type of luncheon meat. Luncheon meat ba siya? So, correct me if I'm wrong. So, super sarap niya. Super sarap iprito. Meron na niya sa mga mga supermarkets. Makikita mo siya sa mga canned goods section. Super sarap niya. Worth it talaga na medyo may kamahalan, but super sarap. So this is one of those interesting facts you probably thought you knew, but actually didn't. Contrary to American mythology, Spam is not an acronym for scientifically processed animal matter or shoulder of pork and ham eater reports. So yung Spam is a combination of spice and ham. So ang dami yung spices. So that's why Spam is very delicious and very tasty. Masarap siyang ipalaman sa tinapay. So, masarap siyang kainan sa morning as breakfast. So, yan ang ating trivia for today. So, nandito na tayo sa ating force and movements of objects. So, dito tayo sa position. So, observe the objects around you. Some of them cannot move by themselves. What can make these objects move? Look at the moving objects. So, what makes them a vehicle move? Paano nga ba, bakit nga ba nagalaw yung mga vehicles, mga sasakyan? What makes the ball and kite move? Paano ba sila nag-move? How can moving objects stop or change their direction? So, yun yung mga tanong na masasagot natin for this lesson. So, position. If you were asked to tell your position right now, what would you say? Maybe you would tell the part of the classroom where you are sitting or standing. So, sabi, saan ka? Ay, dito sa may dulo ng ating classroom. Saan ka? Dito sa may ano te, sa may harap ng pinto. Ganon. Maybe you would also tell how far you are from the chalkboard in what direction you are in relation to the blackboard. Nakaharap ako sa may blackboard te, ganyan. So, you may say, I'm west of the blackboard, about 3 meters away from it. So, ganun, exactly. Exact place, exact position, exact direction, and layo. Describe the position of your teacher's table in relation to windows of your classroom. How far is it from the windows? So, in what direction is in it? Is it in relation to the windows? In this case, the windows are the reference point. When you describe the position of an object, you give the distance and direction of that object in relation to a reference point. So, ganun ang nangyayari when we say and we talk about position. So, yan, movement. So, syempre, meron tayong tinatawag na energy at rest. Tinatawag natin yung potential energy. So, yan, katulad dito sa movement na to. I'll use pen. Ay, wala yatang pen dito sa ating, ano, kasi nagre-record. But this movement, so, pinush ng konti nung bata. So, yan. Pumupunta siya from here sa ating starting point. So, nandun na siya sa dulo. So, ganyan ang tinatawag na movement. Gumalaw. Movement. Paggalaw. So, look at the pictures above. In the first picture, the ball is at rest. If you described its position with the boy as a reference point, you may say the ball is east of the boy. It's about 15 centimeters away from the boy. So, may exact kang centimeters, may exact kang measurement how far yung ball sa boy. So, in the second picture, what do you observe? What is the position of the ball? So, in what direction is it in relation to the boy? Is it farther away from the boy? So, lumayo ba siya? Yes. Times 2, yung naging layo ng ball dun sa boy. So, since the ball has changed its position, it's in the relation to the boy, you say the ball has moved. So, an object has moved, it changed its position in relation to the reference point. So, yan. So, ang ating self-testing questions for this lesson, how will you describe the position of an object? How can you tell the object has moved? So, nabanggit natin niya kanina. So, for example, nasa school ka, but ito, nasa ano kayo, nasa bahay ka lang. So, for example, describe the position of you kung gaano ka kalayo sa TV. So, describe the movements that you make in your house. So, may mga ganun tayong mga self-testing questions na pwede nating ma-implement after this lesson. So, check our time. So, meron pa tayong konti pang minutes. So, magbabalik-aral tayo to make sure that we understand the lesson. So, pag tinanong natin, for example, nasan ka? Anong position mo dyan? So, I'm 15 meters away from the flagpole. So, I'm here at the gate. So, I am 20 meters away from you. So, ganun yung mga specific na type kung paano natin masasabi yung position natin and ano ba yung magiging movement natin after that. So, sa next natin, so, when you describe the position of an object, so, you give the distance, point, and direction of that object in relation to a reference point. So, yan, meron tayo ditong mga activities na nakikita ko dito, but I will not mention it na kasi nga, of course, some of it are self-explanatory. So, yan, meron pang iba dito, pero napag-aralan na natin to last time. So, hindi ko na siya sinama kasi nga magiging pareho na. So, yan, ito yung the best example natin, movement. So, kunyari, for example, to 15 meters away yung ball, pero naging times 2 na malayo dun sa boy nung minove niya yung ball. So, ayan. So, ayan yung lesson natin for today. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. So, click the thumbs up button if you like this video. And leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and questions or future videos or recent videos. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. See you in my next video. Bye-bye. Oh, next. Thank you.